right. The Dolphins are clearly at a crossroads, this Colts game. And I'm not saying if they win it, it's the high road to the ring in the Super Bowl. But definitely, if they lose this game, they're on a fast track to a terrible season. I think if they lose this one, in my evaluation, the season's not technically over, but it's pretty much over. I do think we have a huge opportunity to win this one, but I don't think it's going to be as easy as a lot of people might feel it is, looking at the Colts and looking at their record and looking at Richardson. This is a very difficult team. It's a different animal than we faced before. It's on the road. The good news is the turf, I think, helps us more than them. Hill, Waddle, OBJ, Janu, Achan, Wright, and most are fast, and they're going to be even faster on this track. But they're a little bit of a speed defense, and I think it does help them a little bit, but I think it helps us certainly more. So I want to get into the game. I'm not going to make the call on who's going to win and lose tonight. I like our chances. It's just a lot of variables. I'm going to do it tonight in the live after I get to watch some more film. I'll put my foot in the ground who I think is going to win. But there's going to be a live tonight, as I just mentioned, at 10 p.m. on my channel. So come check that out if you're interested. It should be fun. We always have fun. My man Cody's going to be on. And then tomorrow, the guys, we're going to do AFC East Shakedown on this channel. Everyone from a different team in the AFC East. We're all going to talk about last week and talk about this week. So come check us out there. Guys, the likes, subscribes, the comments, the views, all that stuff keeps me in the biz. Algorithm gods, when they're happy, my sponsors are happy, it keeps me doing my thing. But you guys have been tremendous. Really, I'm so grateful. I hope I can continue to do this. I've been really happy to do this all these years, and it's you guys who kept me going. So I want to give you a shout out and a shout out to Ace Bread, my sponsor, because without two of you, this show ain't going down. Ace Per Head's betting software is the premier white label platform for bookies to manage their players and grow their sportsbook operation. Click the link in the description below to get set up in minutes. Ask for the Curtis promo and get a special introductory discount. All right, so this is a different animal for many, many reasons. Their run defense isn't very good. We know that. Their defense overall isn't very good, although they have some strengths. We'll get into that. But this Colts team has had a much more difficult schedule. And so you got to add context to that compared to our schedule. It's not to say they're a better team and whatever else, but you have to add context in every evaluation you make. So you can see here, they played Houston at home. They had Richardson as a playoff team last year and a playoff team this year, but they almost won 29-27. They put a lot of points on. So that's, you know, a good showing even in the loss. They went on a road to Green Bay. Didn't have Love. Richardson was there. They lost. They weren't able to put a lot of points on. Not easy. Good team. But it's a tough challenge. They kept their points down, although it was a backup quarterback. But we got a backup quarterback, too. They were home versus Chicago. They beat Chicago. Not a great team, but still not a terrible team. It's not as bad as the Patriots. They went against Pittsburgh. Now, Flacco started that game. Well, didn't start that game. He finished that game. But Richardson was in when Pittsburgh was down 17-0. Then he got injured. So you have to give some credit to Richardson here. But they beat Pittsburgh. It's not an easy team. 27-24. Flacco made some mistakes, put them back in the game. They went against Jacksonville 2 weeks ago and lost with Flacco. But look at the points. Look at how many points we put on compared to them. And it was in Jacksonville, 37-34. They lost, but it's a lot of points. And then they went against Tennessee last week. You know how we faced the Titans. They won 20-17. We lost. Flacco was in. They had Simmons this time. We didn't have Simmons. It was just Sweat. They were able to move some bodies with this offensive line. And that's the thing, guys. I think we have, I know we have the skill talent advantage in a huge way. But this offensive line, when you look at this offensive line, including the secondary blockers, the two tight ends, you can see here against our front, They are good. They even got Bordellini, who's coming for Kelly, and he's played really well. They drafted him this year. So this is a deep offensive line, super talented offensive line, and two good tight ends that can pass block, run block, and one of them can catch. Now, if you look at our defense, we got Sealer, and we got Campbell, and Chop, and Agba, and there's guys there, but they're going to have to keep these linebackers free. Long and Brooks, when they got to attack, stack, and shed, they run into problems. When they're free, they do really, really well. So can our front get enough penetration? Can it keep this offensive line and blockers off our tight ends? I mean, off our linebackers, because if not, they're going to have a big day running. They are able to run the football. They protect pretty well. They do add play actions, and they do add screens to pass rush mitigate, but they have a huge time. I think it's up to like almost 3 seconds at some point. So they add the help, but then they get long-term protection. Pittman's going to be back. So we're going to have to slow this run down. We're going to have to create pressure. And we can't really blitz too much because if you have Richardson there, you might have to keep a spy. And then it becomes the quarterback, you take him off the field, but then the spy you kind of take. So then it becomes 10 on 10. So I think they're going to be able to run on us. I think that our defense is going to have some struggles, but if we can contain it enough and get that pressure enough, we will have put our offense in position to win. Now, offensively, you can look at our season. We're averaging 2.4 yards before contact. They're averaging 3.4 against the teams that I mentioned. So you can see clearly this offensive line is doing a much better job than us. But what we're going to have success, I think, this week is that our offensive line is not as good as people want to pretend it to be. But they can even if when Eichenberg gets destroyed, somebody's there's a little bit of a hole there. And if you look at the Colts' defense, their blitz rate is 28th, least 20%. So they're not going to be blitzing too much, although they'll bring in those three linebackers. I'll show you in a second. They're hard, but they're really not good. The one good thing they do is can get hurries, Quiddy on one end and Luda on the other, and they're able to get the pass rush in there without having to blitz too much. So we can't really get off schedule. But the key thing for us with Mostert, Achan, and Wright, look at those missed tackles. 51 tied second to fourth. So their defense is not a good run defense. It is not a good pass defense. So they can do some stuff. And the holes, though, when they're there, if a team can break tackles, if they can keep that defense on the field, wear them down, which is, you know, when you might miss an angle, you might have bad form in your tackling, but when you get hit and hit and hit, your body says, I'm not giving everything, and that's how you blow it open. On this turf, right, Mostert and Achan are going to even be faster, and one of those broken tackles could be a home run hit, could be huge chunk yards, and we don't need to have 193 yards like last week. We're going to need to have at least a sort of parity with the Colts run game, but it's going to come down to this pass game. And this, if you can get them to blitz, you can get them to increase their leverage in the box, then you can get Janu and OBJ and Hill and Waddle off the schneid, especially Waddle. I've shown in my previous podcast how teams are now compressing the space that they're giving him, daring him to beat them, and he hasn't been able to do it. This could be the week, especially when that run game gets going. So we can't get off schedule with penalties and wide runs that get knocked or screens that get taken for a loss, because then they can get those hurries and get those turnovers. They don't really cause a lot of penalties. Last week we beat the Patriots because they were a penalty machine. So there's a lot of stuff that's going in here, but I do think even if you see Eichenberg driven back and Jackson or Brewer, because what we can do with these backs, I mean, rotating the three of them in, pounding away at a team that misses tackles like that, that's not good in the pass defense and struggles in the pass defense, run defense and pass defense, this should be a game where we don't average 12. They're averaging 23 points a game. We're averaging 12. They're going to put points on. They've always kind of put points on. they're going to probably get at least 17 to 20. And so we're going to have to keep up. So this defense can just slow things down. And this interior run game can pop off and make some of these catches. And Waddle or OBJ or John, who could take the weight off Hill and get these points on, it should be a victory. But it is not guaranteed, guys. This is going to be a tough battle. This is a pretty good team because it's built on consistency with a solid offensive line. We're not, but we have a huge advantage in the skills. I think our defense is way better. And so the defense mitigates, slows, gets a turnover, keeps them off schedule a little bit, and then we pound away and get those points, not just field goals, some touchdowns, then we're on our way. His brother's been watching me for years. He can't really get to many games and because of health reasons. This is a game where he's close to where he lives. I want us to win. I don't believe in Greer. I don't believe in this build. I'm like this, men's and men's on McDaniel. But I'm tired of losing. I really am. And for him, I really, really want us to win. It sucks to be here where we're at. It's not over. Let's see. I mean, you saw Butch Barry talking about how they're trending in really good direction. Crossman's like, I don't want to talk bad about to the players in the game and make them feel bad. That was such a used Crossman sale. But if they're right, we'll see. I do think if we win this game and we're able to run the football, we'll win. But try not to extrapolate that going forward. You know, Patriots are terrible. Okay, you did what you're supposed to. Colts, they're terrible. You did what you're supposed to. But let's see how this plays out. It's kind of like last year with the Broncos and the Giants. We are run gods, and then all of a sudden, where did it go? So let's get the win. Let's have a fair evaluation, and then go get Arizona. Maybe Tua's back then, and maybe things can start happening. Big game, huge game. I'll get my final point prediction tonight. This is a very, very difficult because the offensive line disparity is so huge. And Richardson's such an unknown. And we don't know. Maybe Flacco, they bring Flacco in the last minute. Who knows? But anyway, guys, thanks for all you do. I appreciate it really so much. Kurt saying, be well, go Fins. Curtis out. Start building your own online sports book today by getting signed up with AceBread.com service that allow you to book action on sports from all around the world.